Hi, everyone. My name is Wasiu Hadio. I'm an engineer with the Identity Advanced Cloud Engineering team. Today, I'll be showing you how to enable and configure self-service password reset with password writeback to an on-premises Active Directory Domain Services environment.
In this presentation, I'll show you how to configure the required permission for password writeback. I'll show you how to enable password writeback in Azure AD Connect Server. I'll show you how to enable password writeback in Azure AD SSPR Blade. Then, after the demo is done, I'll do a test SSPR for one of the directory sync teaser. Without any further delay, let's proceed to the lab session.
You want to open Active Directory users and computers, as shown here. From the menu icon here, you want to click on View and make sure the advanced feature is checked. Once that is done, you go to the left-hand side of the screen here and right-click on the Roots domain. You go to Properties. From here, you click on Security. Click on the Advanced tab here. Give you some time to come up. Once that comes up, you want to click on Permissions. From the Permissions here, you want to click Add. Here, you want to add an account in our on-prem Active Directory that has a global admin privilege in the cloud Azure Active Directory. For the sake of this demo, I have a service account that I created for this effort. Sync. Let me check. Okay, it's right there. You click on OK. Then from the Applies to option here, you want to scroll all the way down to the last option here that says descendant user objects. Once that is done, from the permissions section here, you click on, you check the box, the right next to reset password. Then you scroll down to the proxy section. We're looking for two items here. Password last set and password local time. So the password local time will be on the left hand side here. Password local time. Keep scrolling down, looking for password local time. Write local time right there. Keep scrolling down, write local time. It's right here. Click on write local time. Then on the right hand side of the screen here, you look for write PWD last set, where PWD stands for password. I'm going to keep scrolling down to where I find write PWD last set. It's right here. Check the box next to that. After that, you want to click on OK. Click OK, click Apply, OK, and OK here. Once this is done, the next thing you want to do is to set the minimum password age to 0, because sometimes in on-prem Active Directory Domain Service environment, the password policies, you know, maybe prevent these settings to be effective. In order to avoid that, you go to Server Manager. Click on Tools, you go to Domain Controller Managers, Group Policy Management. From here, you click on Settings, give it time to load up. Scroll all the way down to where it says Computer Configuration, and right click on it, click on Edit. Right here, you go to Policies, Windows Settings, then you click on Security Settings. Then you click on Account Policies. Then you click on Password Policies. Then you look for Minimum Password Age. In my case, the minimum password age is already set to 0. That may not be the case in your own environment. Just make sure this is set to 0. Click on Apply and click on OK. Once that is done, you exit out of all this environment, minimize this if you want. Usually when an update is done to the settings in some on-premises Active Directory Demonstrated environment, it may take up to an hour or more for that changes to be effective. But for the sake of this demo, I will go to command prompt and force this update to be immediately effective. Then I'll type in gp updates space forward slash force. This command would immediately make the changes I've just made now to be effective. And once that is done, the next thing I will do now is to proceed to our Azure AD Connect server. Right now, we are done with all the settings that we need done in our premises Active Directory server. So I'm going to the Azure AD Connect server now to enable password writeback in it. So from the Azure AD Connect server, you double click on the Azure AD Connect agent here. Give it time to come up. It's loading right now, then you click on configure. Then you go to customize synchronization options, you click next. Then right here, make sure you are using your Azure Active Directory Global Admin account to sync your on-prem Active Directory server to your cloud Azure AD. I probably have a wrong password in there. Let me check and type it again. Then I'll click next. Give it time. Okay, it's synchronizing with our cloud Azure AD now. It's on premises. This is my root domain. Click next. So here you have two options. You have the option to select which of the domains or the OUs you want to sync to the Azure Active Directory. But for the case, for the sake of this lab, I will sync all the domains and OU in my lab. So in my case, I already have my password writeback button checked. In your case, it may not be the case, so make sure the box is checked. You click next, give it time. It's getting the on-prem Active Directory Demo servers ready to get the handshake with the cloud Azure AD blade. So now it's configuring the sync now between the on-prem and the Azure AD in the cloud now. So give it some time for the agent to do what it needs to do to facilitate the synchronization. Give it time. Yeah, it's configuring the synchronization now, setting up the Azure AD Connect Health agent as well. Okay, this is done now. You click on exit. The next thing we need to do now in this lab is to go to the Azure portal and make sure that the password writeback is set up in the Azure AD Blade. So I'll pull up my browser now. We'll navigate to portal.azure.com. There's already a token of a signed-in user as well. So I'll go to Azure AD, Azure Active Directory Blade from my Azure portal. From here, you scroll down to the password reset, and then you click on the on-premises integration here. Right here, in my case, as you can see, the color is green now, showing that there's a handshake between your on-premises Active Directory server and your cloud Azure AD. Then you want to make sure these two boxes are checked, the enable password writeback for sync users and the allow users to unlock account without resetting their password is checked as well. If it's not already done in your environment, make sure that is done. Once this is done, this marks us doing the three things that needs to be done. Then the next thing would be for us to do a test self-service password reset for one of the directory sync users. Before I do a test SSPR, I want to navigate to the users in my active directory and look for one of the directory sync users in there. As you can see, I have Kevin White as one of my on-premises directory sync user. I'll type select Kevin's account, then open a tab and type in aka the ms / SSPR. So I'll put in Kevin's email. If your captcha is not clear enough, keep moving it until it is clear enough for you. I think I see where it is here now. Yes, I'll click next. Then what I'm trying to do is to reset my password, so forgot my password. Type in my mobile phone number, click text. I'm gonna get the OTP. I just came in now, typing in the OTP into this field now. All right, then click next. Now I'm gonna enter my new password here. Click enter. Yeah, as you can see, I've been able to do a test self-service password reset with one of the directory sync user. This marks the end of the demo.
This is how to enable Azure AD self-service password reset writeback to an on-premises Active Directory Domain Services environment. I hope you find this video very helpful. For more information, please refer to docs.microsoft.com. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye.